All right, I'm going to talk a little bit about the comparisons between a Velociraptor and a Brontosauri, and how vegetarianism relates to the whole instance. I know perhaps you've already heard of this analogy, but I'm going on with it anyway. through my little relay. Yeah, I have my little rite of, what do you call it? My rite of spring happiness wreath. I hope you all have made yours. And my gosh, if you haven't, why not? Yeah, I know it's not fabulous, but it's mandatory. You know what I'm saying? So, here we are. It's a moon that wants to be already full, but it sneaks up and it says, "Oh, I'm there." Warning, it's not a full moon. Yeah, they do that, don't they? All of a sudden, it's like half moon, and then it's like, oh, what happened? Weeks went by. And then it's like, oh my goodness. So, back to my discussion of Brontosaurus. Brontosauri is out there gobbling a vegetarian meal. Now, normally, a vegetarian diet of a Brontosaurus is very typically the grassius herbivore, similar to what you see domesticated herd animals now, today, eating. So yeah. However, then there is the other one, the Velociraptor, who is the hunter, who is the picker-offer one, the one who's just completely all the time coming up with, I need this way, I need that way, I have to completely all the time find another cleverance, a new wit, a new method to capture and destroy my new prey. So there is predator appeal going on all the time with Mr. Velociraptor and Mrs. Yes. So there they are. Eating succulents, fats, animal fats, and intestinal, all of that. So there they are. They're eating all of these delectables. And yeah, they do have this clever hunting that has kind of insatiated them into just another way, another method. And so you can't really say, in all reverence, that being carnivoric is bad for the brain. So back to sorry about the mad cow, but back to Brontosauri. Now Brontosauri, pretty sure they have been out there, you know, these herd animals, and they get depressive. They get into a depressive state. They get into that dry, arid areas where they don't have the occasional slug, where they don't have the occasional snail, they don't have the occasional groupage of maybe salamander or some newts all of a sudden sucked up into a bouquet of fresh herbs. So there it is. And so, something may be lacking there in their diet. And so there is Brontosauri, yet again, a longevity maker, one who lives longer even than Velociraptor as a herbivore. However, in a depressive state. Now, I'm going to head on with the suicidal one is the Brontosauri. It is not ever going to be the Velociraptor. The Velociraptor lives to hunt, lives to hunt, lives to hunt, and does not give up. And Brontosaurus is like, whoa, oh my gosh, I'm failing. Something is missing. I'm feeling perhaps too much compassionate. Whoa, I'm heading off to the cliff. Perhaps it's okay. It's okay if I'm drawn there, if it's okay if I'm driven there. It's okay if it's okay. I really don't care anymore. Diet. So, here we are, vegetarian. Here we are, gobbling our vegetarian fare, and my gosh, no, I'm not eating slugs. No, I'm not eating. No, I don't watch American movies either with guns any longer. But, my gosh, that David Bowie video, I mean, that was tragically amiss with him, I think. I think that was absolutely emphatically corporated garbage. Why did he do it? that was just a mindless jerk off into the bushes. I'm not impressed. So, yeah, we don't need that. It doesn't help. Yeah. I guess he needed money. He really needed that much money. So back to, what are we talking about? Brontosauri, yeah. The inclusion into the diet to keep them away from passivity giving up. It's just too hot today. I just don't even want to move off into the shade. I'm just going to stay here and perish. It's just too long a walk any longer. You see, and where Velociraptor is like, what the hell? Perched and waiting. For a shorter while, not living as long, yeah. For a much shorter time. Oh gosh, am I gonna go to hell now because I dissed David Bowie? Oh, god dang. Well, I think I'm in it now. Gosh dang it. I really think I'm in Erebus. If you're feeling depressed, go ahead and eat a slug, a snail, something small. You don't have to go out and eat rabbits, but perhaps that's the one thing missing, you know? Just a little bit of a swampy effect added into the grasses of the herbivore. All right, and I know nobody really knows how long a Texas cow actually lives, do they? Because they eat them so quickly. Chances are they don't live very long. Right, well, yeah, have fun weaving your little hats for spring. Only takes one.